Good evening, everyone. My name is Sai Vinay, working as ITCT trainer in AP Tribal Welfare Residential School, Chittedu, SPSR Nellore District, Andhra Pradesh, under the project of the Naipunya Vikasam, maintained by the Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation with the training partner ICA. Now, I would like to share about my experience while teaching the computational thinking. This is my and my school details. My school having 501 students and 14 sections. Weekly, I got one period for computational thinking. This academic year, in all residential schools, we are implementing the activity of scratch programming through the Naipunya Vikasam project maintained by the Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation. Our students are also participating in Google Code to Learn competition to attract students towards scratch. At first, I let them play some interesting games, and later I said them that you can also develop these kind of games. To make students participate in Google Code to Learn competition, I used to take class after school without disturbing academic sessions, and we made target of 45 days at 4:30 p.m. to 6 p.m. Students showing lot of interest to learn Scratch. In this year, we did 8 projects. From those, now I would like to share 3 projects. First one, Cat Catch and Fire. Second one, Computer Shortcut Keys. Third one, The Last Platform Runner. Actually, 4:30 p.m. to 6 p.m. is the time to play outdoor games. So it's very hard to attract the students to learn Scratch. It's a big challenge to students to develop games and submit to Google Code to Learn competition. Students' themes was implemented first on paper or MS Paint to draw the diagrammatically each object, means sprite, and background, means backdrop, and also written the algorithm. By facing issues like power cut and lack of proper network, finally, with the students' interest, we submit the Scratch projects in Google Code to Learn competition. This is the video for at the time of playing Cat Catch and Fire game. Please watch the video. This is screenshots at the time of playing Cat Catch and Fire game. First, we click the flag button, automatically appear the play button. Once click the play button, the game will loaded, and after then play the game. This is the sprite, means cat object. This cat object moving the ground by arrow keys, and this drums are releases the fire. The cat escapes from the fire and touch the gold coins, score will increase. Once touch the cat to fire, a game will over. This is a procedure of Cat Catch and Fire. In this game, students taken the sprites, dog, play button, ground, loading theme sprite, and 6 types of drums and 6 types of fire bullets and 6 types of gold coins. Let's watch the video at the time of playing the Last Platform Runner game. In this game, compresses the 4 levels. This is the one, first level. The runner sprite reaches the flag without touching the fire. This is second level. In the second level, the runner object reaches the flag without touching the spikes, and the runner object touches the gold coins and score will increase. Let's move third level. Similarly, third level also same. The runner object without touching the spikes and reaches the flag. Is fourth level. It is the screenshots of at the time of playing the last Flatow Runner game. Is one in first level. The player's sprite escapes the fire after reaches the flag by using the arrow keys. Level two, the player's sprite escapes the spikes after reaches the flag by using the arrow keys. Level three, the player's sprite escapes the spikes after reaches the flag by using the arrow keys. Level four, the player sprite escapes the fire after reaches the flag by using the arrow keys. This is the procedure of the last Flatow Runner game. In this game, students taken the mini sprites, costumes, backdrops. Main sprites are player, fire, ground, flag. This is a screenshot at the time of playing the computer shortcut keys game. This is the first we can click the flag button, automatically play will appear, and we can click the play sprite. After automatically some topics are appear in the screen: general, basic, Windows, MS Office, Chrome, Firefox, ASCII code, internet. For example, we want Firefox, we can click the Firefox sprite. Automatically shortcut keys of Firefox. In this game, students taken the 25 sprites and 14 backdrops. The game team is displaying the computer shortcut keys. Students started developing new projects using Scratch. Students are implementing the own ideas on Scratch. Students' competence of self-directed learning. It's a great to develop such a wonderful games at this age. By implementing these two students, it is useful to improve their logical thinking and technical skills. Through learning Scratch, students are getting capable of learning other programming languages. Students' responses very good. Even they used to come in their leisure hours and do practice. After completion of the Scratch course for about 45 days, students changed a lot and coming out of phase. New ideas with the different projects based on their interest, means students' interest, students' hard work at this age, I got motivated and impressed a lot. Eighth standard students acting as a master trainer for ninth standard students. And now, finally, I conclude that thanks to Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation and Naipunya Vikasam Project and AP Tribal Welfare Residential Educational Institution Society and Sunil sir, GM of ICA, and my state coordinators, Surendra sir and Ranjit sir, and my district coordinator, Venkat sir, and also our district trainers. And thanks to my school principal sir for wonderful supporting of throughout this academic year. And special thanks to Sonia madam and Vipul sir, they helping me throughout this academic year while teaching the computational thinking. And also thanks to Veda madam for developing me this presentation and video. And finally, thanks to my students and also thanks to everyone.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Fanendra Kumar. I'm working as an IT and CT trainer in APSWRS Pedavegi, Andhra Pradesh, under the project of Naipunya Vikasam maintained by the Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation with the training partner ICA. Now I would like to share about my experience while teaching the computational thinking. This is about my school, my details and my school details. And my school having the 640 students and total 16 sections. And weekly I got one period for computational thinking. This academic year, all residential school in Andhra Pradesh were implementing the scratch programming through this Naipun Vikasam project maintained by the Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation. Students have also participated in Google Code to Learn international competition, and nearly 10 projects are submitted from my schools. Students are showing a lot of interest to learn the Scratch. Why? Because it is having the game and fun also, and animations and their real life where they see in the mobiles. They try to develop their games by using the Scratch. Their students develop the number of projects using the Scratch. Now, I would like to highlight these two games, board game and Bug and the Wire. And also, I would like to explain about challenges while I'm teaching the computational thinking. It is very difficult to me to solve the student doubts. Why? Because I'm also a learner, where students come up with different ideas, like how to develop a bubble sword game and free fire game and shooting games. And have an idea to that student, dividing the students into groups. Because it is easy to work on their games by communicating with the group members. And after that, their ideation of that particular game. Then I give in comments on like how many sprites are required, how the background will appear, and how many levels, and how to change the levels, how to change the score. These comments are given to the particular student. Then student automatically improvise and work on that particular game. Now I explained the student developed one of the game, board game, and this game procedure have this game. Board is a hero. Student named as board game, and it has having the cars, board, coins, huddles, and balloons. And this game will be controlled by using the mouse buttons or keyboard buttons with using the left and right and up and down arrows. And this game having the 6 levels. And if the board touches the end point, and it moves to the next level, or if touches the huddles, the board automatically destroyed and it will comes to the initial position. Now I show the how the game will appear. This is the game environment, and this is the board. And this will be controlled by using the left and right arrows. The board touches these coins, the score will be increases, and it shows the high score. And it touches this flag or the end point of the level, and it automatically moves to the next level. So then next level also having the different types of coins, different types of huddles. And this will be developed by the group of 5 member students, and they are working on the different environments, and they are finally implementing this game. And this is also another level. Now I would like to share this is the board game, the pictures, and I would like to explain another game. This game will be developed by another group of five member students. This is named a student named as a Bug on the Wire. Why they are giving this name? It did having the three wires and bugs moving on that wire, and cat escaping from that bugs. Initially, this cat having the 3 chances. If the bug touches the cat, automatically the chances will be decreases. And also during this game, lives also come on that wire. If the cat touches the life, the chances will be increases. Like this, the game will be developed by the group of 5 members. It is. I'm also shocked. Why? Because when I was a child, this game will I seen in the keypad mobiles. Now the students are developed that game, the Scratch. So now I show the procedure and how the game will look like. And this is the three wires, and this is the cat of the hero of this game, and these are the lives, and these are the bugs. If the cat touches the bugs, and the game will be automatically stopped. And this having the score and the time. How the score will be the means. How much time the cat is on that wire. So here it touches the bug and the game will be ended. So these two games are developed by the group of 10 members. How much the Scratch's impact on the students means they are try to implementing or try to solve the different games with the logics. Even me also, I can't say some of the times, sorry, I didn't have an idea. But students solve these logics, critical logics also while these using the Scratch, and also applying these logics and conditions on their regular academic subjects also. I'm very happy on that. And the student interest, how the students are being changes the Scratch means, student, even if we have in a laser hours or the game periods, they come to my lab and work on their particular game, taking the permission and also taking from permission from the principal, sir, give me the chance to develop my game. And student principals are also giving their permissions and giving the support to develop that game. And on the time also, I'm also helping to the student to develop that particular games. So like this, the entire school, 640 students are having the minimum basics on this Scratch, and also they have developing knowledge, game developing knowledge also can be increases. And now I finally conclude that thanks to Naipunya Vikasam project, IPSSDC, and thanks to Sunil sir, GM of ICA, and thanks to my state coordinator Surendra sir and Ranjit sir, and my district coordinator Ravideja sir, and thanks to my school principal. He is supporting very well throughout this academic year, and now he is becoming a district coordinator in Vizag district, which is located in Andhra Pradesh. And a special thanks to Sonia ma'am and Vipul sir, they are helping me throughout this academic year while teaching the computational thinking. And also thanks to Mansi ma'am for developing me this presentation and video. And also finally thanks to Social Welfare Department and my dear friends. Thank you.
Good evening everyone. I am Divya Nagalakshmi and I am working in a government tribal welfare ashram girls high school in Anantagiri Mandalam, Visakhapatnam district in Andhra Pradesh state, under the project Naipunya Vikasam, which is maintained by Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation with the training partner ICA EduSkills Private Limited. Now I would like to share my experience and my thoughts on implementing computational thinking and implementing Scratch in our school. In our school, we have totally 640 students from 3rd class to 10th class, and we are teaching Scratch from 5th class up to 10th, and we got weekly one period for every class to teach computational thinking. Here I would like to mention one main point about our children, that as our school is a tribal welfare school, all our children are from tribal areas. We all know that tribal areas are very far away from development. They don't even have basic facilities, like there is no proper roads, there is no proper medication, no proper transportation, and no proper shelter. And these people's financial situation is also very bad. They can't even afford the daily basic needs, which are healthy food and clothes and all. So these schools helping those children to overcome these problems by providing them all with along with the good education. So now coming to implementation of computational thinking and Scratch, we are implementing computational thinking in our school from past 2 years, and we introduced Scratch programming in our school from last academic year, from 8th class up to 10th. Students are very interested in learning Scratch from the beginning itself because of its cartoon type looks, animations and sounds. These additional features made them to feel more excited in learning Scratch. But here we got a problem, that lack of English knowledge. Students don't understand the English language. They don't have minimum basic knowledge in English, and they can't even able to understand the language, Telugu language also, which is our state language. They only know their local languages, like some tribal languages. So this becomes more challenging for me to teach the Scratch, and this is also a challenge for them to learn because Scratch is completely in English. So I started teaching each and every meaning of each and every block, and I started teaching the use of each and every block by practically showing them how each block will work in the program. but still they are very confused about the order they must follow while building a program. So by observing them, I got to know that they may not even understand my words, but they can able to understand my actions. So with the help of some students, I use a different way to teach the Scratch to them. So I have made Scratch itself a live game which students can play with their friends in the classroom, and also they can play it within in the playground also. So for that, I divided the students into some groups, and in each group there is one student who act like programmer, who gives the instructions, and some other students will act like sprites who will follow the instructions given by the programmer. And also there are some block palettes. Here we can see the block palettes. These are block palettes. These block palettes contains their respective blocks, and programmer will use these blocks to instruct the sprite. So the programmer will give instructions to the sprites by using these blocks, and the sprite will follow the instructions given by the programmer. And here on these blocks, I noted down each and every meaning of the block in Telugu for better understanding of them. So they got to know the meaning of each block. So if any instruction given by the programmer is wrong or it is not executable, the sprite will not follow that instruction, and it will not move, it will stand still, and will shout out loudly as error, error. So this playing method helping the students to learn and to get familiar with each block. So they got to know the meaning of each block, and now they know how to use and where to use the blocks in the program. So another thing they need to know is they should know the specific order they must follow while placing the blocks one by one. So I used another method, in which I related algorithms with writing script. So we all know that algorithm is a step-by-step procedure to solve any problem, or step-by-step approach to perform any specific task. So students will use this step-by-step procedure in building a program. While building a program, the student already know the output they want. So as they know the output, they will plan accordingly to get the desired result. So for example, if the student want to draw a rectangle, they will plan the steps to draw the rectangle. So they should think about how many sides the rectangle have, and what is the length of the each side of rectangle, and what is the angle between each side of rectangle. So accordingly they will plan, and they will write down one algorithm. So here we can see the algorithm. So what is it? First take a pen and draw a straight line. So straight line like this, and next turn 90 degrees and again draw a straight line. And turn 90 degrees and draw a straight line. So now the student got the rectangle shape. In the same way, students can use this step-by-step procedure to write the script in the Scratch also. To get the rectangle shape, these are the blocks they will use in the Scratch to get the rectangle shape. Here the demonstration I demonstrated in the video. So this is the script, and this is the execution, script's execution. So here we got the rectangle shape. So by using this method, writing of program becomes much easier for my students. So as knowing the problem and designing the solution in a specific way is the main thing and first thing in a program, I related algorithm topic with the Scratch while teaching to students. And finally, my students becomes more active in writing scripts, and now they can write the programs in a specific order, in a correct order. So these kind of activities took a large difference in our students. So these kind of activities shown a large impact. These shown a large impact on our students. Students, we all know students are much more interested in playing games than listening to classes. So I introduced playing method while teaching classes. So they got attracted to my classes and they started enjoying the class. They slowly started understanding and they developed their capability of writing program. And some of the students are very good at programming in Scratch, and they also started teaching Scratch classes to their lower classes also. This is very good outcome from my students. And the best thing happened here is my students participated in the Google Kotulan competition, which is conducted by the Google India, to encourage the students and to exhibit their creativity. So my students use the Scratch platform to participate in that competition, and they made some projects, like they made some games and animations and uploaded them. So here I mentioned some of the games done by our students. These are the projects done by our students. First, this is the story animation. This is the story that shows Thirsty Crow story. We all studied the Thirsty Crow story in our childhood. So there is a crow and it is very thirsty and searching for water. So it saw a pot with little water and it uses stones to drink the water. So this is the story of that crow. And my students made some animation for that story in Scratch. And next, this is another project made by our students, which is Draw with Dots. They named it as Draw with Dots. This is the game, drawing game. In this, we have some dots, and also we have a pencil, and we have some colored circles here, and also clear option. So we need to click on the color circle which we require, and the pencil will turn into that color. And after selecting the color, now we will color the dots as shown to draw a drawing. So here we have a clear option to clear the old drawing and to start the new drawing. This is another project created by our students. And next project is animation. So this is the animation of solar system. We know the solar system. Sun and eight planets are rotate around the sun, and each planet describes about themselves by coming out, and they describe themselves and they will go back. This is the animation created by our students. So next project is Giga's adventure game. This is a normal adventure game. There is a character called Giga. This is Giga, and he should move forward and he should overcome the hurdles in his way. So these are some projects prepared by my students. So coming to students' interest, my students become more interesting in learning Scratch and in learning computational thinking. So they feel very happy and they feel very excited to come to lab and practice the Scratch classes. And also they even don't care about the timings, and they often come to computational thinking classes in their leisure hours. And also they sacrificing their game periods to come to lab and practice Scratch. And also they coming their break periods and lunch periods also. They even started practicing in extra night classes. So these are the images taken in night study hours. So you can see here. So this much of interest they have to learn computational thinking. So by these activities, finally I conclude that these activities are helping students to improve their logical thinking and also improve their technical skills. Mainly they are helps to improve their interpersonal skills. So finally, I want to thank for giving me this opportunity to share my experience and share my students' activities in front of all these dignitaries. And I would like to thank APSSDC and ICA for making me a part in this wonderful project Naipunya Vikasam. And I would like to thank our state coordinators Ranjit sir and Surendra sir. And also I'm thanking our district coordinator Satish sir, and special thanks to my coordinator Suresh sir, who are supporting me always in every aspect. And also special thanks to Vipul sir and Sonia ma'am for providing our students with the CS Paathshala curriculum. And also special thanks to Nikhil sir for his valuable suggestions in preparing presentation and also in preparing video. And thank you everyone.